How's that? Better. So, if you didn't hear it, most people can hear me. My father used to say he could hear me in a crowded shopping mall, so. Took the train down, came in to the Grand Hotel, beautiful, get up to my room, and the first sight that I see is Becky crossing the street with the bongo drum on her back. And all of you, I watched the whole thing. It was really fabulous. So it's really a pleasure to be with you here today. Unlike Clive, I will not be talking about life or death kind of situations. We are a marketing communications company. And as part of putting this together, we thought it would be really helpful to first ground you kind of in what is Havas and what are the types of things we do and the types of people we have before I take you on our Lumina journey. And I like to think about when I look at the name of the company, Lumina Learning, I look at it from the lens of bringing light to leadership. So that's what we're focused on in terms of the different applications I'm going to share with you of how we've used Lumina and the various tools and how we're going to be going forward over time there. So, first, a little bit about Havas. As Becky said, we have 20,000, I'd like to say, talented people, 700 agencies. We're in over 100 countries, $2.3 billion in revenue. It's a very big, very complex structure that we're working with. We're balanced and diversified in terms of our revenue. You can see how it's divided up in terms of the various regions. People are quite often surprised to understand that while we're a French company, the U.S., from a revenue perspective, is the largest revenue. And then you can see the various sector breakdowns. So we work across a whole lot of industries, and our people are engaging with different companies in those industries. Oops. There we go. We have three basic divisions, if you will, or networks. The first is the creative network. You may have heard of some of these different agencies through their brands. What's flashing here is the Palu Pledge, which was just a titanium-winning campaign at Cannes. It won in four or five major categories, and it's a really just an interesting insight into some of the work that gets done. The team out of Australia that worked on this actually came up with a concept. The people of Palu were very upset about their natural environment and how they could continue to retain it, even though they had lots of tourists descending on them every year. And what the team came up with is this pledge that when you arrive there in immigration, you actually have to sign a statement in your passport that says you're going to follow these principles when you're there, and it's about respecting the environment and whatnot. So it just took away all the awards this past year in Cannes. We're very proud of that. We also have a large media division, which is broken up into various brands, as you can see. The woman up in the left-hand corner just won CEO of the Year for APAC in the media industry. And we also have a very fast-growing healthcare division, which used to be part of the creative division and got broken out about a year and a half ago because this space, there's a lot of healthcare professionals here, is so growing so rapidly that it really needs its own set of organization capabilities to focus on it. It's the largest one in the marketing advertising industry. Our mission, to be the world's best company at creating meaningful connections between people and brands through creativity, media, and innovation. And the meaningful connection piece is something that you will see kind of thread throughout our culture. We don't want to just make TV ads, digital ads. We want to make sure that they have purpose and meaning and that they're making a difference in the world. Making brands meaningful is really what we have all of our people anchored on right now. And it really does make people stop and pause when you have to kind of say, is this a meaningful piece of work I'm putting together? Was that a meaningful conversation I just had with someone? How meaningful was I with my team this week? So it filters not just through the work we do with our clients, but how we all behave. These are some of the clients that we work with. You'll see they're pretty big brands, very global. Some of them are handled locally out of the countries. Some of them are handled through global client representatives that run teams that are across many, many countries to deliver the services to these organizations. This gives you a little snapshot of what we're about. So it is true that our data team in London actually predicted the election through their data analytics, and they did it by following all the comments on social media and how people were responding in social media in the US. But not one television station would broadcast it because they didn't believe it. So it was pretty compelling. So all this work happens in villages. Our villages are our integrated approach to how we work. So about 5 years ago, we started a together strategy, which was about bringing media and creative and our other functions together in one building. Yesterday, I was in the London village. It used to be 10 separate agencies located all around London in different villages. And now there's 2,000 people all residing in a really stunning village in St. Pancras. Anyone that would like to visit it, it has won a lot of awards for the space that it provides for our employees. It's a very unique, very collaborative type space. I also wanted to share with you a little bit about how our employees talk about their villages. And so I'm going to show you a video of a Snapchat contest we had where we reached out and said, send us a snap of your village and tell us what you're most proud of.
Hi, I'm Ed, and this is my Havas Snapchat tour.
Hi, my name is Carl, and this is the best place to work in the world.
Welcome to Barcelona.
Welcome to our global village.
We are approaching the Montreal habitat of Havas.
And welcome to Havas Village, New York.
Hey, guys.
Morning, Havas Village.
This
is the Havas Village.
Mi nombre es Diana Oros y pertenezco al equipo de Havas Tijuana.
Rodríguez.
Hello guys, I'm Rafael Andreis, CEO of Havas Village in France, and let me introduce you to Margot, who's going to show you around the Havas Village France.
Hi guys, this is my first dish. Let's go!
Not a nickel to my name, hot to bus, here I came. Could be brave or just insane, we'll have to see.
Maybe me in the sleepy town, I'll sit one day, the lights are down, you'll see my face.
Amazing.
Fantastic.
Shit. Long.
Divisive.
Awesome.
The restaurant is the only place in the village where you can eat and drink very good coffee. And
so one thing I like to do.
Chicago, the artsy parts of the street. If you want to come inside, there's one thing you gotta do. You gotta dress in all black and caps and easy boots.
And that concludes my tour of my Havas Edge in Carlsbad. Hope you enjoyed the show.
That's all, guys. Hope you enjoy the tour.
Good night, New York! So hopefully that gives you a little sense of our amazing people. That was a compilation of all the wonderful Snapchats we got in. Everything we do is grounded in our values, so these are the values that we have at Havas, and these are woven through all of the talent programs we do in terms of how we assess people, not only for their performance, but how they behave against these values. Very critical part of how we do our work with Lumina as well is making sure that these values come alive and are part of our programming. Recently, we were acquired by Vivendi. It was a bit of a family deal. If anyone knows anything about Havas and Vivendi, the common denominator is the shareholder, the Bolarés. And so it was a very friendly acquisition, if you will. And it's been personally interesting because I now have the opportunity to also do some work across these Vivendi companies and to look at integrated programs where we're working not only with Havas employees, but also across the different entities of Vivendi. So a little bit about my team, which I think is interesting to understand. So 3 years ago, my role never even existed. In the advertising industry, kind of the focus on talent and growing and developing talent isn't something that was kind of at the forefront, if you will. Advertising is pretty much known for people hopping from one agency to the other, back to another one. And so when I did some work in the Havas creative group, Yannick Bolloré, who's my boss, quickly realized that there's something in kind of this focus on talent and developing leaders and helping make them stronger, and that it's something that we should focus on. So I formed a very small team in New York, a very kind of scrappy entrepreneurial team, It's a pretty young team, so I have a lot of interns who become employees. I think we're on our third of that. There's only eight of us. And what we do is basically develop innovative experiential talent development programs that go across the whole Havas group, and now a little bit of Vivendi. These are some of the areas that we've been focused on, and what I want to share with you today is some of the specific types of programs we've designed and developed in partnership with Lumina, and how Lumina is woven through many of those programs. This is just also, obviously, we have local HR teams in each of the agencies who we work with and help support our initiatives. So, Lumina. Let's talk about our Lumina journey. So the first initiative that we engaged Lumina with is our Next Gen program. This is our high potential leader program, so this is very, very selective. It has about 50 people in the class. And they have roughly about 10 years experience. They have to have been at Havas for 2 or 3 years. They have to be people leaders. And it's really quite an intensive program in terms of we take them through 3 different modules. Each module is a week long. Takes place over about 15 months. So you have 2 modules in 1 calendar year and then the other one at the beginning of the next year. We take them to different parts of the world for each of these modules so that they get a cultural experience as well as a leadership experience. And Lumina has been really a foundational element of this program. As I said earlier, in our industry, most of these leaders who are now 10 years into their career may have worked at some other competitors and whatnot, have never had an opportunity to actually focus on themselves. And to literally kind of be in a room for a week with a group of cohorts who they haven't met, who are from all over the world, and go on a discovery process of who am I as a leader, and understanding what do I do well, and where do I have an opportunity to do better. And we've woven the tools in. We start them with the spark, which is an easy way to kind of bring them into it. And you've got a little sense of our people. We have people who are, you know, creatives, who are going to be kind of not used to this type of environment necessarily. We have data analytics, we have CFOs, we have quite a variety of people in the room. And what's astounding is that no matter who they are or where they are from around the world, they take the spark ahead of time and they get it when they arrive, the first day we take them through it. And every single one of them to a T says, how'd they do that? This is scary. Oh my gosh, it's so me. And it's really an amazing sight to watch as you see this very culturally diverse group of people all have kind of the same reaction, like, how did they know that? And it starts them on this process of, first of all, embracing who they are, and then kind of learning more about it. And we really spend a large chunk, to use one of Becky's American words, I can use that, a large chunk of the time in module 1 is just that self-discovery process. And most of those leaders have never done that before. And it's this, it's that light. It's that first light that comes on in terms of their own leadership and leadership development. You'll see each of the modules kind of has a different focus. As we take them into module 2, we build in emotions, so they get another kind of rounding out of the Lumina spark. And then we do the Leader 360. And that has been very interesting because we've had to engage, obviously, their leaders from their agency, their peers. So it kind of opens up this world of, what are they doing at that Next Gen thing? What's this Lumina thing? And you get a lot of positive response in terms of, this seems really interesting in terms of what you're doing. And we're actually partnering with Becky right now to really kind of do a customized Leader 360 based on the learnings we had with the last Next Gen class and how we can make it work even more powerfully for our teams and for the types of people in our agencies. Next Gen, I think I mentioned, is about 50 people. They come from about literally 50 different agencies in about 20 countries, so it's a pretty diverse group. This is a little bit about, you know, kind of the Lumina as a baseline. And if you see this scrolling feed, one of the things that our cohorts do is they form WhatsApp groups pretty quickly. And when they first get the Lumina, you'll see the splash. They all start sharing them and lots of little kind of emojis about it. And I think it really kind of keeps it alive in between modules because that group is constantly talking and connecting. And while it might seem funny at times, they will be using language like, that was so red of you. And you see how they're carrying it forward into their daily life in between the modules. This is the feedback that we've had from our participants, which is pretty astounding. We do a pretty robust survey after every module. So you'll see 96% said, I discovered leadership approaches that can be implemented with my team, agency, or clients. 98% said, I will be able to apply the learnings from my Lumina Spark assessments. And 100% found the Lumina assessment to be valuable to them. Some of the other comments here you can read about, you know, I'm definitely a better leader and manager since I returned. These are kind of the comments after they've gone back and had to actually apply what they learned in their agency. So super compelling in terms of how it has impacted our next gen group. What's most rewarding for me is when I'm traveling around and I'm in a village and one of their leaders comes up to me and says, what did you do? Because they're so different now. They're like behaving much differently in this scenario or that scenario. And that I think is the most rewarding piece of it all. Here's a little bit from them directly. Can we just have a little more volume? Thanks.
I think the biggest learning I've gained is in understanding a little bit more about myself. We spend so much time understanding our clients and understanding our consumers and getting into their heads. And if we don't really truly understand ourselves, we aren't able to help or solve any problems, really.
Ever since I've went through the Lumina profiling, things about me that I didn't quite initially agree to, I'm seeing it coming true that that's really me.
I definitely have become much more aware of myself as a leader.
And what I need to do and what I need to focus on, where I need to strengthen and what to ease up a bit.
It'd be really useful for me to learn how to use emotions more and to understand people who emotions are actually guiding them.
There's definitely been growth in my relationships with people.
I have seen personal and professional growth.
It's really identified who I am and maybe highlighted uncomfortably at times who I'm not.
It's like you see this whole different person.
Getting to know yourself, I think that's one of the hardest pieces, but one of the most rewarding.
So one of the things we like to do is when we find something that works with our people, we try to figure out other ways we can use it and apply it. And in the last next gen module, we actually had them use their Lumina profiles for a CSR activity. So we were in Costa Rica and we worked with a local architect artist, this Francesco Brocchi, he's there in the middle. And he does eco-friendly interactive structures that people can interact with. So we actually brought them out to this park and we basically said, you're gonna, you know, the structure was already there and we said, you're gonna complete the structure. And they had 8,000 beer cans from a local vendor. Beer cans apparently don't hold the light or the heat. And so they had to go through a process of assembling these panels that then were pulled together and constructed there. And the purpose here was to bring shade to a park that never had shade, and it's now a permanent structure there for the people of that town in Costa Rica. And it was this was on one of the last days, so they all went into this exercise with their Lumina profiles and actually speed reading each other. They were in mixed groups and figuring out who's going to do what and how we're going to go about it. So we're also playing with, which I highly recommend, using it in different ways to help your leaders continue to grow. This is another initiative we did, which was a smaller group of about 10 people from around the world that were brought together in California to work with a group around climate change. This was part of Havas's commitment to initiative with the UN. And we gave all of those people the Lumina Spark beforehand. So the first thing when they came into the room was they went through a Spark exercise so that they'd get to know each other more than just, you know, hi, I'm Sally and, you know, I'm from the UK. And it really provided, they had 2 weeks to do this, basically transform this nonprofit's marketing materials and campaign, and they did an amazing job with Lumina at the base of that. So another program that we've recently launched this past year is our Fem Forward program. And this program was designed because we saw a need at that senior manager director level where the women weren't being promoted as fast as the men. And we did a lot of research. There were a multitude of potential hypotheses as to why that was happening. Some of you may have heard of things like the ambition gap, the confidence gap. It's typically people who have about 7 to 8 years experience. They maybe, you know, have a new partner. They may be starting a family. There may be outright bias in the group they work in. And so we've designed a program called Fem Forward, which is about helping them grow and develop. And we did two pilots, one in London, one in New York. And the Lumina, again, was kind of the foundational element that we use in the first module to really kind of help them get in touch with who they are as leaders. And again, it is pretty astounding when you put a group of people who don't know each other, who've done or doing something like this for the first time, and they have that kind of aha moment. Just to give you an idea, it's been wildly successful. The London cohort finished probably about 8 weeks ago. We've already had 5 of the women in that group be promoted. The New York group just finished in mid-June. We'll be doing Paris in September. And we have Lumina practitioners, you know, matched up and working with us on each of these programs. We're getting into kind of the delicacies of some the language differences. In Paris, we will do the Lumina Spark portion, allowing for French so that, you know, the kind of emotional piece of it when people are talking about themselves. And then the rest of the program will be delivered in English because that's our CEO wants everything to be in English and you have to push the French people, he says, to speak English. So on International Women's Day, Yannick sent a press release out saying that we were going to be committed to rolling this out more globally. In that press release, he did note Lumina and the partnership with Lumina. And in 2019, we'll be focused on LATAM, APAC, and we have too many requests in terms of various groups that want us to come in and run the program there. So I'm sure this will have some legs to it over time. But again, partnering with Becky, the team, and a lot of different practitioners on delivering this in each of the different countries, because the cultural piece is really important. We really try to have at least one practitioner who is from that country or is very familiar with the culture. It seems to make a big difference with the people in terms of the delivery of the program. One of the exciting things that's happened is as these particular programs, NextGen, Fem Forward, et cetera, have come through and been very successful is that we start to see our senior leaders asking more questions. So this is Jorge Perkovich, who heads up our LATAM group. And he was our closing speaker at our last NextGen class's final module. And I asked him to share a bit about his leadership journey, and he did an amazing job of talking about the fruits of his journey. For him, it was a very cathartic experience. He had never really stopped and thought about what was his journey and his career. And it was the first time he took anything like a Lumina. And he was so kind of enlightened by it that we're now building a program with him for his region. And you can see he's got a wide and varied region where we're going to be doing Lumina Spark and some other components with the CEOs. So one of the things he wants to do is get the CEOs to work more collaboratively and to understand each other better. And so it'll be kind of a focused couple-day session with the CEOs from these countries, and it'll be a little bit of an experiment for us in terms of a different level audience and how they engage around it. And so we'll come back and share more. Becky can share more on that. We've also had a number of our HR people certified. We felt it was really important to make sure as we start to spread the Lumina wealth across that we have some of our HR people able to help and support it and talk about it. And they're, if teams, couple of the next geners have gone back and said, I want to do it with my team. So it enables us to also have local people who can help out and make that happen. So this is just a cadre of our amazing practitioners that we've had. They've really been just tremendous partners because most of what we're doing, we're building it. So we work in partnership with them. We have ideas. We say this is what we think we want to do and how we want to design it. And then they come in and we work together to finalize it. And I have to say, this journey has been amazing, meeting these people, working with them. My team has had an amazing experience with them. And I can't say enough about, you know, Becky in terms of the partnership, because I'll ring her up and I'll say, you know, I was thinking, and she knows that means it's probably I'm going to be asking for something or trying to do something that you all haven't done before. But the answer is never no. It's always let's talk about it. Let's figure out how we can do this. You know, I shared the 360 example recently, and that's the can-do attitude all of you have in the room, and it's been really fantastic. And I'm sure this page will double or, you know, triple in the next year as we roll FEM forward out and continue to move forward with the next gen program. Our CEO has taken the Lumina. I just want to tell you that. So that's Yannick Bolloray. That's him speaking at FEM Forward New York. And he came in and he went, what is this thing? What are these colors? And he was kind of doing this little like dance thing around the mat. And I said, we'll get you to take it. So before Next Gen, he took it. And you know, I think the more you can engage your leadership, the better opportunity you have to get more people involved and engaged around Lumina. So it's been amazing for that. So a little bit just to leave you with why it has worked so well for us, because I know a lot of you are trying to figure out with your clients how to innovate, what are some of the things that you can do, and they may not all be in kind of the wild and crazy industry that I work in. So a couple things. First of all, it creates a common language. So across our people that have been in these programs and others, they start to kind of speak with the Lumina terminology, which I think is something that then, you know, has huge power and potential across your organization in terms of how people interact with each other. It's strengths-based. One of the things that we were very sensitive about, and I originally had a slide in here that had some of your competitors and kind of like why we don't like them. So, but then I said, well, that's kind of not in the right spirit. But, you know, we're a very millennial-driven industry. We live in a very fast-paced, agile kind of environment, and things are constantly changing. And it just doesn't help people if they feel bad about their assessment. And one of the things that I love about the Lumina is nobody ever feels bad. They feel like they have insight, but they never feel bad about it. And that to me is so important because I think the leadership journey has to be one that starts with that positive foot forward. It's adaptable to your program needs. As I said, you know, we've probably done things with Lumina that nobody's done before, and it's been fun doing that. It establishes a foundation for personal growth. So most of the people in our industry, again, have not ever really had this investment in themselves. And this starts them on something that, you know, really, at least when we track the first class that we did next gen, they're still using and still talking about. Drives behavioral change. There was a lot of conversation earlier about behavior in Becky's chat. It's really important. We're trying to bend the curve on who these people are going to be as people leaders. We're trying to give them an intervention that their leaders never had. You're a good account executive? Go be a group account executive. Have at it. Hope you do well with those 20 people. They don't know anything about themselves, and they don't know anything about their people. So this next group is going to be a much more enlightened group of senior executives at Havas. It's easy to use. Our people have no tolerance for complex things. They won't do it. So it had to be something where it was quick, easy to take, you know, not overbearing. And we found that to be the case with all the tools. And it resonates. You know, I've already shared a lot about that. It's been something that is eye-opening. They feel privileged. They feel special that they have the opportunity to learn about themselves and to learn in this way. And Lumina is a true partner. It's been an amazing journey so far. We have a lot of other plans. It's one of the burdens of having programs be successful is you then have to run them. So then I've actually divided our teams so that we have the run program group, and then we have a couple that are just focused on innovation as we continue to design and develop new programs across Havas. And the final thing is, if I can ever not be on a plane for, you know, 2 weeks at a time, I am going to get Lumina certified in the next year or two. So that's the final thing. So thank you. And I'm happy to take any questions.
Behind me. Hi, you mentioned that you use Lumina Emotion as mm-hmm. part of your program, and I just wondered in what context do you do that? Do you use it in groups? Do you use it individually? How do you go about doing that?
Both. So pretty much everything in Next Gen, there's like the individual component, the pairing up and chatting with someone else, and then also different experiences and sharing in groups. And the other thing we try to do is filter in speakers on particular areas or topics or that might be able to kind of reinforce it as well when they've had an experience. And those are both internal and external people. Yeah.
How did you get the senior managers buy-in? What was the tipping point?
How did you get the senior managers buy-in? What was the tipping point to make it go much larger?
It's an interesting question because when I first went into the role, the readiness was so low. People really, they were kind of like, I don't know really what she's going to be doing, something with the people. And so I basically said, here's what we're going to do with the Next Gen program, and here's the outcomes we expect to deliver. And that's it. And then I didn't say, could I please use the Lumina profile? And, you know, I think this might be the best thing for us. I have laid down a pretty clear philosophy of test and learn. So everything I do is a pilot first, and then we learn from it, tweak it, and then run it global. So Femme Forward, I said I'm going to take two big villages that I know have decent readiness to do a program. Well, I'll be able to pull together a class pretty quickly, and we test and learn. And so, you know, for the most part, things have worked. And nobody, if you have success in your pilot, nobody asks any questions about, like, let me understand what exactly. They're like, the people are so happy. What are you doing? Keep doing it. And I think that's been the biggest learning, is having the senior leaders understand the relevance of investing in people, running really good experiential programs, and then seeing the difference in those people and what those people feed back about the programs. Most of our success has been because the people come out of these things and they're just transformed, sparking your way to transformational leadership. And I don't have to then, you know, sell anything else. And so when I said to Yannick, will you take it? He's like, sure, I'll take it. It's good. He still needs to have his debrief, though. Other questions? Yes?
How did you first hear about Lumina?
It's actually kind of interesting. There was a previous leader who was using a different kind of engagement organization to run something that was kind of like NextGen, and they had it in one of the modules. So when I went into the role, the first thing I did was say, let me see what they did in this last one and maybe like what worked and didn't work. And having taken a number of the other assessments myself over the years, it, for me, when I saw the Lumina piece, I was like, I think this has the simplicity and the positivity that will work for our people. Because everything I have to look at is, you know, we have an interesting audience that we have to address. So that's where I found it, through the other organization, and then met Becky and continued on. Yes? Right. So NextGen has people from all markets, and some of them come from very small agencies. And one of the things we did was we actually added more people from certain parts of Asia Pacific and LATAM in the last program to make sure it was broadly diverse. My learning, which is, you know, probably more NextGen focused because that's where we have, you know, a big global cohort, is they're all the same. When we do our employee engagement survey, the issues are the same all around the world. You don't get big distinctions because this generation now has had access to all information. And when they come together, you can't see the differences. I always worry about, oh, you know, are all the kind of French going to stand together and, you know, all the Americans, and then we'll have the little APAC group over in the corner. They're so interested. This is an opportunity they may not ever get again to learn more about how life is for other people and other cultures and other villages. And so they kind of lean right into that. And we don't really, other than making sure we have enough participants from those regions, we don't really we look at them all as the same in terms of participation. Now we do take them to places, so they've been to Costa Rica for a module. Previous class was in Kuala Lumpur, because we want them to understand more as global leaders what's going on in kind of up and coming, growing markets that aren't as developed, you know. And so I think for us, we kind of look at them all as they're a next gen participant, and we haven't seen a lot. I mean, APAC can't get Femme Forward fast enough. The HR leader calls me one more time. I'm like, we're coming. We're coming. So we haven't seen a lot of challenges going across different regions. Yes.
Do you have any quantitative or qualitative data on how this has impacted the retention of your employees globally?
Yeah, so one of the most exciting things that happened yesterday was the launch of Workday, because we have not had a common HRIS talent management system, so we will be able to pull the data on all our former participants. We've tried to kind of keep track of them. We do know in NextGen there's been a large number of promotions in terms of people that have been through the program, but I can come back to you on that. We went live yesterday with the HR team. We go live with the four largest markets on August 6th, and then by mid-2019, all of Havas will be on a common talent management HRIS system, which is like a dream for someone like me, because we'll be able to track them, look at data, et cetera. And one of the other things we're looking at doing is also creating a little bit of like a badge system where their nameplates and email will have badges. We have other programs we run too that don't have Lumina in them, but so that it starts to become a distinction. If you've been through one of these programs, you basically have a badge on your email so that people feel proud about it. And they are very proud to be part of these programs. Okay. Thank you very much.